Time can work with us. When you're on chemo, your life depends on the clock.
Boy, the fun never stops, does it?
Which is why I have a proposal for you. I'd like you to move into our guest house.
Try to avoid any extracurricular in the house, if you know what I'm saying.
Yeah.
Or against us.
So, I told her that I was gay. I was just trying to let her down easy.
Uh-huh.
Thank you very much, Robbie Hansen.
And for Joanie, only time will tell.
It's not just an alarm clock. It's also your heartbeat. I figure if it works for dogs, then why not for Hannah?
This is the nicest gift I've ever gotten.
Can I have my turnovers, please?
I'll give you 3 a day. Any more than that comes out of your paycheck.
Press, darling.
Sometimes it's hard to know whether you're his doctor or friend.
Forget that. Are you his lover?
It's none of your business.
Since your speculation, you'll soon be announcing a wedding date.
That's insane. We're not even dating.
So you're saying you're not interested in him in a romantic way?
I never said that.
But you now admit, after months of denial, that you do have chemistry.
Well, there's something there.
Can you give us a better handle on that? You've been ducking this issue for the better part of the year.
Are you negotiating book and film rights to your story?
Is it true that you've asked Mr. Moran to undergo extensive plastic surgery to meet your specifications for the perfect man?
No, of course not.
So you think he's perfect?
Is there any truth to the rumor you'll soon be interning at the White House?
Oh, my God. Mother!
They're not wrong, dear. America does have a right to know.
Stop!
All around me are all of your hearts. I still don't know how you got me through the mad parts. And then you tell me that even angels fall. Sometimes when it's quiet, I can hear you call. When I think of your smile,
strange happened.
You made your own breakfast.
I left my wallet at Barkery yesterday, so I went back late after closing at O'Neill's.
Yeah?
And, I thought I saw somebody in the front, you know? I figured maybe there was a burglary, so I went around the back to peek in. Never guess what I saw.
Doug.
How'd you know?
I let him crash there. He's just in between apartments, so I figure, you know, cheap security.
Mm-hmm.
Did you know he sleeps in one of those big round doggy beds?
What can I say? It's a little different.
Joanie, when I tapped on the window, he woke up barking.
Really?
Yeah, and I don't mean like wolf, wolf. I mean seriously, he was gonna take my ankles out.
He was probably just pretending, you know, to ward off any intruders. He's very smart that way.
Yeah, well, it was kind of spooky. I'll tell you, if I were you, I'd seriously reconsider this dude.
What do you want me to do, Robbie? Fire the guy because he barked at you?
I'm just saying, there's a lot of wackos out there, okay? Now, how much do you really know about this guy?
Enough to know he wouldn't hurt a flea.
Shoot yourself, sis. But in my experience with employees, where there's smoke, there's fire.
Kyle, I got here as soon as I could.
Hey, Sid, look at this tent. It's only 4 pounds and it seems sealed.
Great. So what's the surprise?
All right, listen, you know I'm not exactly what you'd call sensitive, but lately I've been having these confusing feelings.
That's totally understandable given what you're going through.
Exactly. And now the question is, what am I going to do with my life? Well, I just figured it out.
You have?
Yes. I want to spend it with you.
That's so flattering. But
Oh, Sid, no, I know. We've been doing this weird tap dance for so long. I just feel like we need to spend some real time together.
What do you have in mind?
The Grand Canyon. 2 weeks. Just the two of us and the Colorado River. No family, no cancer, no work, nothing. Just nature. What do you think?
Don't you still have another course of chemo?
Oh, yeah. Dr. Millman said I can finish it when I get back. I know this is it's a leap of faith, all right? But this could be the beginning of a great adventure. Our adventure.
Can I have some time to think about it?
I don't mean to spring this on you, but I couldn't contain myself.
Hi. Heather.
Good day, Robbie.
So how are things?
Things are quite stable, thank you. If you're looking for Dr. Hansen, he's just finishing a procedure.
I guess you're still mad at me, huh?
Oh, you mean over that little business where you pretended to be gay so you wouldn't have to go out with me?
Rob, what a pleasant surprise.
I have an errand to run, Dr. Hansen.
Take your time, Heather.
Hi, Heather.
Still mad at you, is she?
Well, she's not furious anymore. More like extremely irritated.
Oh, she'll get over it someday.
Someday?
Or as soon as she finds a boyfriend, whichever comes first.
Doug?
Joanie.
Doug, hi. You just ate an entire bag of pig's ears.
I paid for them.
Well, that's not the point. Pig's ears are revolting.
Not ours. Ours are made from the finest pork products, roasted to perfection, naturally dried, and vacuum sealed.
But they're not made for human consumption.
Who's to say? For example, you eat hot dogs, don't you? Would you like me to list the ingredients in a good old-fashioned wiener?
Okay. Who's your friend?
Sheila. At least, she reminds me of a girl I used to know, named Sheila.
Where'd you get her?
On the corner, on the street corner, a few blocks from here. She's abandoned. So I thought we could, you know, maybe put a sign in the window, maybe give her a good home, you know, and... Unless that's a problem.
No. Why don't you take her over to my dad's?
Yeah.
And he'll give her a checkup and shots and all that kind of stuff first.
Okay. I'm all over that.
Okay.
Okay. Come on, Sheila.
Doug.
Ah.
By any chance, did you see Robbie's wallet around?
Oh, yeah. Yeah. Found it on the patio. Come on, Sheila. Let's go see Papa Hansen. Come on.
Get away from me. Don't touch me.
All right, let's just calm down. You just had a little too much to drink. Hey, what's going on in here?
Leave me alone.
Okay, we're just trying to help you. Hey, calm down.
Don't touch your hands off me.
Patrice, get the restraints.
How could you do this to your own mother?
Is she okay?
Passed out. Get her some oxygen.
Who is she?
Jane Doe. Indigent. Passerby found her walking down the middle of the street. She came this close to getting hit by a bus.
Marked dehydration. She must be living on alcohol. Start an IV. Get a CBC SMEC 7. Send blood and urine for a tox screen.
We can't keep her here, can we?
Call county. Have her admitted on a 24-hour observation.
Right away. What did she say to you?
I don't know.
Here we go. Yeah. Hello? Hi. Hi. You must be Dr. Hansen?
Oh, hi, yes. You're Doug?
Hi. Your receptionist went to the mailbox. Left you a note.
Joanie said you'd be coming by. Well, what a nice looking dog. Where'd you find her?
On the street corner, Fremont and Governor.
Looks like she's got some sheepdog in her.
Yeah, on the mother's side. I'm guessing, you know, from the eyes. Father's probably an Australian shepherd.
You know your dogs.
Yeah.
Let's get her up on the table. There we go, sweetie. She doesn't look malnourished.
Just depressed. You can tell by the eyes, the way the jowl hangs. You can always tell by the jowl. Something's not right at home.
Assuming she has a home, you did say she was astray.
Right.
No collar, no ID tags?
Nothing like that, no. No, she's a stray, all right, that's for sure. Joanie and I were gonna try and get her placed.
Well, you shouldn't have any trouble. She's in great health. Unusually good health, in fact, for a stray.
I'm surprised she has a private attending. Most of these people don't have many visitors.
Well, she came through my door. Follow-up is customary. Can I have a look at this, please?
Sure.
Her blood sugar levels are way too high, 340 milligrams.
Maybe from the dehydration?
Oh, CBC's normal. Doesn't make sense. Repeat the glucose and check for ketones. She's had a blepharoplasty.
What?
A cosmetic procedure done here around the eye.
How can you tell?
Well, see the tiny suture line? Well, that was a nice job. Not cheap. I'm a plastic surgeon.
Oh.
Has a social worker found out who she is?
No one's ID'd her yet, although we do have a lead. The honor of your presence is requested at the marriage of Megan Lombard.
Megan Lombard?
The name ring a bell?
Yeah, I went to junior high school with a Megan Lombard. Her parents were friends with my parents. It's Mrs. Lombard.
Kyle, what are you doing?
Checking out the gear.
You didn't buy all this stuff, did you?
Most of it's rented, but couldn't resist a tent. It's a beauty, isn't it? We can go around the world in this baby.
Yeah, you know, I haven't made up my mind yet.
No, I know, Sid, but it's just, you know, this is the first time since I've got the cancer news that I feel really pumped about something, you know?
Right. And I would never want to put a damper on that.
And I wouldn't want you to feel pressured, really. But you're not quite there yet.
Right.
Ah. Can you put your finger on it?
It's a great tent, but it comes with a huge elephant. Major issue that we've both been ignoring. Kyle, we're gonna be alone for 2 weeks together, day and night.
Ah. We haven't really,
Right. And making love with a man for the first time in a tent isn't exactly my dream come true.
You're absolutely right. It was selfish of me not to consider that. Now, just out of curiosity, you have a better idea?
I was thinking about something a little more traditionally romantic in a less rustic setting.
You know, I hear there's a great little inn out by Narragansett.
Now you're talking.
What would the timing of this be like?
Same thing better.
Tomorrow night?
Great.
Good.
Okay.
Hey, Joanie, did you get my wallet?
Yeah, it's right here on the bed.
Oh, yeah, thanks.
And just for the record, Doug grabbed it for safekeeping.
I guess you decided to charge me for the favor.
What are you talking about?
I'm missing 40 bucks.
Are you sure?
Yeah, I'm positive. I just cashed my paycheck. I had $400 in here, now I got 360.
I'm sure there's an excellent explanation.
Yeah, maybe he needed a new doggy bed.
Come on, Robbie. All right, the guy's a little strange, but I can't imagine that he'd steal any money, especially from you.
Meanwhile, I'm $40 short, and I'm not gonna let it slide. Either you say something about it, or I will.
I'll take care of it.
Maybe you should check the till while you're at it.
How are you feeling, Mrs. Lombard?
Do I know you?
I'm Sydney Hansen. You used to play bridge with my folks when I was a kid. I went to school with Megan.
No. You're mistaking me for somebody else. And if you'll excuse me, I have to get out of here. I need a drink.
You can't do that.
Why not?
Because you have diabetes and you're in no condition to leave. We need to run more tests.
That's fascinating, but I am leaving and you can't stop me.
Well, then congratulate Megan for me.
I won't be attending the festivities.
I'm sorry to hear that. I'm really sorry for Megan.
Well, it's too bad, but I don't have the wardrobe right now.
Well, that's all that's stopping you. I'm sure we can figure something.
What is the matter with you? I'm a drunk, in case you haven't noticed.
Your drinking is the worst thing that you can do for your diabetes. You need to stop or you're gonna die.
I'll be sure to remember that next time. I was sorry to hear about your mother. I know she never much liked me. But then again, I never much liked her.
Morning, Johnny.
Hi, Doug.
Everything all right?
Yeah, fine. Oh, certainly haven't had a very busy morning, have we?
We're not open yet.
There's that.
You sure everything's all right?
Yeah. Yeah. No. When I gave Robbie back his wallet, $40 was missing.
And you think I stole it?
No, not at all. I was just wondering if you saw it on the ground, or maybe it fell out, or, you know, something.
Hey, Joanie, if it ever gets to the point where you don't feel you can trust me here, I hope you'd feel free to push me out the doggy door, okay?
Okay.
We're open for business.
Wow. I'm sorry.
You should be, man. This is a silk tie.
Yeah.
I hope you're gonna pay the dry cleaning
bill. We'll do better than that. We'll pay the dry cleaning bill. We'll get you another one.
Right.
I'm sorry about that. Look, since the drink was on you, lunch is on us, all right?
Right. Well, accidents happen.
Yeah. A chair. Here. Here you go.
Thanks, Robbie. I'm such a klutz, man. I'm beginning to think I'm just not cut out for this job.
Hey, don't worry about it. Like he said, accidents happen. Listen, this may sound like a weird question, but are you seeing anyone?
No, not really. Why?
Well, I think I may have the perfect girl for you. You just need one thing.
What's that?
A dog.
Oh, wait, I have a dog.
Okay, well, then I think we just may be talking a date with destiny here.
Yeah?
Oh, yeah.
Hi, Heather.
I've got all Sheila's lab work back. She's clean as a whistle.
Great.
You want me to take her back to the Barkery?
Well, before you do that, I'd like to make sure she doesn't belong to someone.
She doesn't have tags or an ID tattoo. I checked.
Yeah, well, just to be thorough, I'd like to check for a microchip.
Microchip?
Yes, the latest in pet tracking technology. They implant a small chip about the size of a grain of rice and encode it with identification. It's supposed to be painless and very effective. Yeah, you just stay, Sheila. You just stay.
How would we know if she has one?
Well, you don't, unless you have a pocket scanner. Here we go. Sheila, they usually put them right in the shoulder area. Mm-hmm.
Here, Sheila.
Well, well.
What do you know?
Spackle it to your hips, dear. It'll be faster.
Oh, no, no, Mother, you're wrong. Dreams are the best place to eat. No caloric intake.
Suit yourself. Oh, I miss playing solitaire. It's tough finding a game on the other side. So, you're still anxious about Kyle?
Oh, I've come to terms.
A tent, for God's sakes. Well, at least you're about to get it over with.
Can we please change the subject?
It's your nickel.
What happened between you and Mrs. Lombard?
Oh, you remember. At least you should. You were right there.
Was?
Sure. Used to sneak down and spy on us all the time. You didn't think I knew.
but I can still hear those stairs squeak.
She's thinking carefully.
Decisions, decisions.
And it's very wise, because this is a big trick.
Uh-oh.
Whoops. Didn't you just play the Queen of Hearts?
Are you accusing me of cheating?
Oh, no, Evelyn. Of course, I'm sure it was an honest mistake, but...
Or maybe one of us has just had 6 or 7 too many highballs. I'm not drunk, dear, if that's what you're insinuating. You're always drunk, Evelyn. Ask anyone in town.
Linda.
That was uncalled for, Linda. Apologize.
Apologize? I don't know how you let her go out in public half the time. I don't have to stay here and take this. You're right. You don't. So now would be a good time to leave.
Linda.
Well, aren't you something?
Evelyn.
Dear friend.
Tom.
Please.
Linda, for God's sake, would you say something?
You let her go.
Folks, wait a minute. Evelyn?
Thanks.
Tom. I'm
sorry, Jim.
Somebody had to say it, Jim. Do you remember now?
Good morning.
Hey, Dad. How was your walk?
Cold. Solitaire?
Not me.
Your mother loved that game.
Well, Sid got the card gene. I just got the Jones for caffeine.
Hey, I may have had some luck on that dog of yours, Sheila.
Oh, the stray Doug found.
Yeah, turns out she's not a stray. Had a microchip ID. Put in a call to the owners, but got a machine, but I'm sure they'd be calling us back.
Great. Mm. Thanks. Something wrong?
No. This Doug is kind of odd, isn't he?
A little. But he's so nice. And he really knows his dogs, Dad.
Yeah, I've seen that. What do you know about him, anyway?
He has an impeccable background. Great references. The works.
Oh, good. Well, be sure to tell him about Sheila.
I will.
Morning, Dr. Hansen.
Hi, Heather. We didn't hear anything back from Sheila's owner, did we?
No. Maybe the owner's out of town or locked in the refrigerator. I read once about a robbery where they locked the owner in the fridge. The dog went for help, but by the time they got there, the owner was frozen.
Well, why don't you try animal control, see if they have some more information?
Will do.
There we go.
Hello.
Hi, I'm Charlie Abbott.
Hi.
Hi. This is my dog, Costello.
Hi. Has Costello been to see Dr. Hansen before?
No, this is his first trip.
Is it a general checkup or is there just a specific complaint?
Well, he squeals a little when he hits the brakes. Maybe you could check his pads?
Brake pads. I get it. You'll need to fill out these forms.
Oh, let me help you.
Don't.
Sorry.
It's okay. I do it all the time.
This is Lombard?
Here's a waste of 7 bucks.
That stuff would have killed you.
You came all the way down here to tell me that?
Came to give you chloropropamide. You should take one pill in the morning and one before you go to bed.
You just don't get it, do you? I'm not asking for any help, and I'm certainly not taking any pills, so don't waste your breath. Just leave me alone.
You have every right to drink yourself to death. But you have no right to do this to Megan. If you're hell-bent on killing yourself, you could at least wait until after she gets married. Here. Now you have no more excuses.
Morning, Dad.
Hey. Hey, you better get baking. I just sold our entire stock of Rin-Tin Slim to this woman who breeds golden retrievers.
Great. Doug, last night I was sitting around doing some paperwork for the IRS, and they were interested in some information about my employees. I realized I didn't have much on you. In fact, I don't have any.
You said I didn't need a resume.
Well, you don't, but it's for the government, you know. They just need to know basic kind of stuff.
Basic stuff? Like what?
You know, like where you went to school, where you were born, where you grew up, that kind of thing.
It's complicated.
I have time.
Well, I was born in rural Newfoundland, if there's any other kind, and when I was in kindergarten, I was found to have an IQ that rivaled Oppenheimer, so subsequently I was sent to Zurich to work with a team of elite scientists on a plan to save Venice from tidal destruction, but in midstream, no pun intended, I was awarded a Rhodes Scholarship, became a championship pole vaulter, and had an affair with the princes of Madagascar, and subsequently to that, was recruited by the CIA to help reorganize the United Nations. That's it for kindergarten. Yeah. Do you want to hear about first grade?
Hello.
Hi. You must be Heather. I'm Hank Thomas from Animal Control. You called about a dog with a microchip ID?
Yes, Sheila.
Well, her name is actually Crash. I need to speak to the vet in charge. Is he still around?
Right here. Dr. Hansen, this is Hank from Animal Control.
Hi, you're here to pick up Sheila?
Crash.
Crash?
Yeah.
We know the owner. Nice lady, but she travels a lot, and her dog sitter is kind of a space cadet.
Hmm. Why do I have the feeling that you're not just here to pick up a dog?
Frankly, we have a little problem with the young man who took the dog.
Doug?
Oh, is that his name? We only know him by description. I was hoping that you might be able to help us find him.
Hmm. Why don't we go in the back?
Sure.
It's not the sex, per se. Of course not. It's about the intimacy.
Exactly.
Mm-hmm. Guys never get that.
Sometimes I feel like I'm his doctor and that I'm crossing this invisible line. I feel like I'm about to make love to a patient.
Creepy.
Maybe we waited too long.
Ah, another female issue. See, with guys, timing doesn't matter. It could be 10 minutes, 10 years. They're like rhinos. It's all about the horn.
Ladies, your table's ready. If you'll just follow me.
I actually got you a little something to jumpstart your evening.
What?
An aromatherapy massage kit. It is the very latest in modern consummation.
Thank you.
Nectar of love. Hi, how you doing? It's very metaphysical. At least that's what it says in the magazine ad.
How does it work?
Okay. You take the nectar, and you place it in this glass thingamajig, and then you let it gently warm over the flame. I don't know what that is. Oh, I almost forgot the most important thing.
What's that?
Okay, before you begin, you have to have all the lights out. We're talking pitch black.
Why?
To decrease the visual in order to enhance the tactile. Apply the nectar until he's reached his desired spiritual state, and then jump his bones.
To love serenade.
All right, to our great adventure.
I'm very glad to know that you feel the same way, too.
It's good.
Yeah.
bubbly.
How would you like a massage?
All right. I'll never turn one down.
Okay. Should you lay down and I'll get the lights?
Okay.
Boy, that oil smells interesting.
It's very metaphysical.
Oh, what happened?
I stubbed my toe.
You all right?
Yeah, good, fine. Okay, right. You might want to flip over.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. Okay.
It's a pillow.
Okay.
All right.
Here comes the oil. Oh!
It's really hot.
Oh, Kyle.
Ow.
I'm sorry.
Ow! No, it's cold.
Here,
no.
Wipe it off.
No, it's okay, it's fine. It's
oh
fine.
My Just... God, I'm so sorry. Are you okay?
Yeah.
This isn't working, is it? Well, maybe we ought to just forget it before somebody gets hurt.
Joanie, you got a minute?
Sure, Dad, what's up?
Good morning. Hello, little sweetie.
Hi, Green Bar.
I had a visit from the animal control people late yesterday. They told me for the past few months somebody has been freeing dogs from their trucks, and they think it's Doug.
Why in the world would they think that?
Well, for starters, they've got eyewitness descriptions that pretty much match up.
Well, that sounds pretty flimsy to me.
Joanie, Doug told me he found Sheila at Fremont and Governor. That's where the truck was at the time she was taken. And it's not the first time he's done it.
Is he in trouble?
It's illegal to obstruct the workings of a civil agency. There are certainly fines involved, possibly prosecution.
Do they know his name?
I only know him as Doug, but I couldn't lie about the rest. I told him you were his friend and that I would ask you if you could possibly tell them where to find him.
You didn't tell him he worked at the Barkery?
Does he? I'll be damned. I thought he just helped out there from time to time. But if you do see him, I'd suggest you say something. The police are on it, and they'll eventually track him down.
Hey, Dad. Thanks.
Hey, Robbie.
Hey.
Hey, man. Listen, thanks for the intro. Heather is really a terrific girl.
Yeah, she sure is.
Yeah.
She went okay with you two, huh?
Yeah, well, I think so. She's amazing.
Well, she's very sweet, and I don't know about amazing.
And as far as I'm concerned, qualifying for the Olympics is pretty remarkable.
You talking about the same Heather?
Yeah, you didn't know she was a gymnast?
Oh.
Oh, man, you should have seen her. She did this backflip off the bed.
off what bed?
Well, after the movie, she wanted me to come over and see her place, and, you know.
Yeah. Sure.
Anyway, thanks again. She is a find. Man, I'm telling you. You know, not many people in this world today that would donate part of their trust fund to the homeless.
Heather has a trust fund.
Oh, yeah. But I thought you said you knew her. I got it.
Sorry, we're closed.
Yeah, we need to talk to you for just a second.
Hi.
Hi.
We have reason to believe that a man who's been taking dogs from animal control has been in your shop.
Oh? Why is that?
Well, we found this at the scene.
Yes, well, we have lots of customers.
We have a witness who overheard him introduce himself to one of the dogs as Doug.
All right, Doug works here. Or at least he did until yesterday.
What happened yesterday?
I cashed his last check. He left town.
Do you know where?
Yes. He left the country to Newfoundland.
Thanks anyway, but I'm not going to the wedding.
Why not?
Why do you care so much anyway?
Because I understand what your daughter's going through. Before my mother passed away, we grew so far apart. She died a stranger to me. And there isn't a day that goes by that I don't wish I could change that. If that's the way you want to end it with your daughter, then fine. There's nothing I can do to stop you.
How do I start over now? I don't even know how to stop drinking.
I think the phrase is one day at a time. You could still go to that wedding today if you want to. It's a leap of faith, Evelyn. Everything worthwhile usually is.
Hey, Joanie.
Hi, Doug.
Look, I take it something's wrong, or else you wouldn't have me stay out of the Barkery today. Am I being fired?
No, you're taking a leave of absence.
Did I miss something?
Yeah, you missed the part where the police came to the Barkery looking for the guy that breaks into the animal control trucks and lets all the dogs free.
Oh, that part.
Look, here's your severance pay. I'm sorry, it's not more. Bye, Doug. Good luck.
Joanie, I'm sorry. Joanie. Sorry, I wish there's something I could say.
What can you say?
Well, for the record, I was born in Newfoundland. I did go to kindergarten there, but that stuff about CIA, the United Nations, being a Rhodes Scholar, well, I made that up. But while I was in kindergarten, my mom, she got a job at a nearby tent, well, nearby, a couple hundred miles away, and sometimes she'd be gone longer than expected, so she got me a dog, keep me company, Mel. Mel was a Newfoundland, of course. Me and Mel, inseparable, you know, kind of like Tom and Huck, only the dog boy version.
What happened after kindergarten?
Grammar school, high school, college, therapy, bad jobs, disastrous relationships, more therapy, and a lot of moving around. Providence is my 14th town.
You must miss Mel.
Yeah, Mel taught me everything I know about life, which is part of my problem, so I've been told.
What do you mean?
Unconditional love is a little hard to come by in the real world. Not to mention a long-lasting chew toy.
Doug, I think you should stay. We can always just go to the police,
no,
and we can explain to them
can't.
The whole situation.
It's time to move on. You've done so much for me already. And I can't say I'm surprised, because I knew from the minute we met that you were a real animal lover.
Just my imagination, or are you actually crying in your beer?
Need me a line.
Wow, I haven't seen you pout like this since Buckner blew the World Series.
Great, now I'm really depressed.
So who's the girl?
You wouldn't believe me if I told you. So what do you want?
Something you'd buy me a beer.
What's the occasion?
Doug left. For good.
Sorry, sis. You really liked that guy, didn't you?
Well, you know, I mean, he had his problems. But
Yeah, he was special. Hey, here is the $40 he took from your wallet.
I can't take it.
Why not?
Well, Doug didn't steal it. I lent it to this girl after I closed up the other night. She got locked out of her apartment. And, you know, just slipped my mind. Why don't you let me get you that drink?
Don't bother. Drink yours.
Going somewhere?
I figured it's mine. Might as well try it out. Unfortunately, I don't think Tinker's too keen with the idea.
He'd probably prefer a bed.
Well, he's no fool.
I'm really sorry about last night. I was having such a hard time switching gears from doctor to friend.
Well, don't apologize. It was all my fault. And this whole Grand Canyon fantasy had nothing to do with us. I'm scared of dying, Sid. Pure, old-fashioned panic. And, not exactly the best state of mind for romance.
We were both really forcing the issue. What was I thinking with that oil?
It'll happen when it happens. Or it won't.
Yeah.
And we've always got the tent, right?
You said that tent was really warm, huh?
It's rated at 30 below zero.
Something for us to cuddle up with in there.
Deluxe air mattress with one down comforter.
Shame you didn't save some of that champagne.
I have an extra bottle in the all-purpose mobile cooler.
I have only one more question.
What's that?
What are we still doing out here?
Thank you.